Conference, your source for JVM knowledge.
Oh, yeah, thanks for having me, Greach, Bluefire IT, for sending me. My name is Code Turk, and today we are going to compare some Pokemon with IDEs. So, what's Pokemon? No sounds. Aww. Yeah. It's Pokemon. Welcome, Jeff. So this is giving me some inspiration for beginning. And what's Pokemon? Pokemon is coming from Japan. It's about two trainers, and two trainers are battling with each other. The Pokemon are battling with each other, so they are going to fight with each other. And next slide, please. So the battle of the IDEs. Welcome. This is Dukachu. This is the first Java Pokemon ever. And yeah, please tweet. It will be nice. Thank you. So together with Dukachu, we are going to catch some Pokemons, or in this case, we are going to catch some IDEs. Yes, nice. I'm waiting for more votes, thanks. So, what did, I had a fight with my colleague about who had the best IDE. So it was really looking like a Pokemon fight. So he was saying, oh, your IDE sucks, and it is not good. And so he was getting his Pokeball. A Pokeball. I can throw it if you want, but I don't do it. So he was doing like this. He was throwing his Pokeball, and like this, he's saying, "Ah, I choose you, Eclipse," and an Eclipse coming out of it. So this is the Eclipse logo. So he was, So we were almost battling. So I was also taking my Pokeball. This is me, and I was saying, "I choose you, IntelliJ," and IntelliJ come out of it. And yeah, we were battling to each other. So let's battle then. So we were battling, and who will win, you think? Is it IntelliJ? Who would think IntelliJ is going to win? Eclipse? Yeah, I see well, yes. Thank you. So there's no winner. So because an IDE is personal, so don't try to force it to other people. It's just like an opinion. Just move along, and this is my colleague. He's a Java programmer. He likes Eclipse, but he was also watching IntelliJ. So introduction, who am I? My name is Code Turk. I'm from Bluefire IT. This is my boy band. already an old photo, but we like to learn and to go to conference like this. So it's really nice. Working at the Rabobank, one of the bigger bank in the Netherlands, in Utrecht. Yeah, I like to work hard, play hard. And I like to drive the motorcycle. I go into the stadium and I'm playing baseball. So, enough about me. Yeah, I'm also a member of the Speaker Incubate program. So this is my first conference, 45-minute talk. So please be sweet for me. So an introduction. So I already told something about the fight, the battle between between us. And I'm going to tell you something about my research, what I did. And I also tell you something about in which situation, which IDU you can use. And the goal is that you need to reconsider your choice for an IDE. IntelliJ is good, but don't lose the focus, I would say. It's like Chuck Norris and Bruce Lee. You never know who's winning. I'm a big fan of Chuck Norris, by the way. They have also a nice Jenkins plugin. I like Star Wars and Star Trek. I like Linux, Windows, Mac, seen by. Yeah, there's a lot of discussions you have there. And now we have a new one. The battle between the IDEs. You have a lot of IDEs, and you also have editors. So, but we are going to talk about IDEs. So what's an IDE? An IDE is helping you with coding. It's give you a debugger, everything editor. And an IDE is something that's just to edit text. So I'm checking Eclipse, NetBeans, and JetBrains, IntelliJ in this case. And we're checking Visual Studio Code. So I'm now going to tell something about my research. I did a research on Twitter, and I asked people, what's your favorite IDE? So I Venkat was retweeting it. It was very cool. And it was boom. Everyone was retweeting it. It was hyped or something. It was really nice to see. So I got a lot of responses, almost 700. So that is nice to see. So my question to the audience, who is programming Java? Okay. Who's programming Groovy? Oh, wow. JavaScript? Kotlin? Oh, almost that whole row. Nice. So, yeah, I was also checking which programming language are people using. So this was the results. It was a lot of people were using Java in my network. And the second one was JavaScript, and the third was Groovy, so that's very good. So the main role of the people were that they were mostly back-end engineers, or front-end engineers, or other architect students. So, yeah, who's using IntelliJ, I already asked. Who is using something else? Okay, what are you using, for example?
VS Code.
VS Code, okay, good choice. And other one, I saw there some... Okay, oh, nice.
Sublime,
okay, text editor, wow. Who is using Emacs? Yeah, nice. Respect for you. maybe VI? Is people using VI? Oh, that's nice. I'm also using VI, by the way. So yeah, like expected, everyone is using almost IntelliJ. And the second was NetBeans. There was it was really nice to see that it was so close. I didn't expect it. I was thinking, hey, Eclipse is second. Who is using the free edition of IntelliJ? Okay, nice. You also see it in the research. 14% was using indeed IntelliJ, the community edition. And I'm also have a giveaway an IntelliJ license. So yeah, please hold on. And without Kotlin support, you see that it's less because Kotlin is made by JetBrains. So you would see everyone for Kotlin is using IntelliJ almost. So then you would see that it's less. It was a good choice to create Kotlin, I think. So yeah, we see the Groovy developers are even using more IntelliJ, and Java developer less. Yeah, and Kotlin, like expected, it was 90%. So yeah, it's made by JetBrains. And a research by JetBrains itself. Yeah, they're using IntelliJ. Yeah, and Eclipse on second. And you also have a company that's called Snyk. And they also did a research, and they were saying, I'm using the most of the people using IntelliJ, and the most are the paid ones. So the technology radar, I am also watching every time. I recommend it because you see the latest hypes, trends, and that kind of things. And also with Snyk, it's an upcoming. A tool to check dependencies, NPM dependencies, and that kind of things for security. So, yeah, I can, and maybe I'll wait. Who wants to switch to another IDE? Maybe, no, nobody. Okay, that's good. You like your own IDE. You also see it in my research, only 12% is want to switch, maybe, and the rest is saying, buckle off. So I ask my colleague, why are you using Eclipse? Why are you not using IntelliJ? So yeah, so I ask it him, and this is my colleague. It's a Greek one.
Hello, I'm Kostas Baroonis. I'm a Java developer. I'm a colleague of Co, working together the last 3 years making Java applications. And today I'm going to talk to you about writing code and using a specific IDE. Personally, I strongly believe that the developer should write code well and not fast. However, if it is to pick up a specific IDE, I would definitely go for Eclipse. And I can explain to you the reasons why. First of all, I like Eclipse supports the feature with multiple projects in your perspective, like using sets. Second, I like that you can tweak Eclipse and get maximum performance regarding memory handling, disabling animations, validations, and stuff like that. Third, I like that Eclipse has a big community where you can get lots of information regarding questions or changing things. And most of all, I like Eclipse because I can also support the open source community. And this is the reason I chose to write Java code using Eclipse as my preferred IDE. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Nice. You will see it also. Yeah, I think he is also loving IntelliJ, but yeah. So, the Eclipse Pokemon. So, what he said, it's open source free. You have a lot of plugins for Eclipse. It's open source free, and you have the multiple projects in one view he like. And also if they have no reference with each other. He liked that. And you also have Eclipse in a browser. So you can use Eclipse J. I don't know if I pronounce it good, but you have a web browser and you can type your code there. Why do you need to use IntelliJ? Yeah, it has a great support, of course. It's mostly fast. And you have a lot of plugins. Why are you laughing? Yeah, you have a lot of plugins. It's debugging, auto-completion, code completion, and everyone in my team was using it. So that was the question from the community. So why they are using IntelliJ? And why do we need to try Visual Studio Code? Now, this is the Visual Studio Code Pokemon. And it has a lot of plugins, and it's mostly lightweight. So it's low resources, so it's really fast. And you now also have support for Java when installing a plugin, so that's nice. The NetBeans Pokemon. NetBeans Pokemon that people like because of the Maven and the integration of Gradle and Maven. And it works out of the box. Open source also, support. And James Gosling is a huge fan of it. And he is the father of Java. He created Java. And then we have Emacs. So, let's try Emacs and just try it. Now, this is Emacs. And I have no idea how it works. Yeah, because you have, it has a lot of shortcuts you need to know. So, yeah, you probably know, I hope. But I know a few ones, and this is one of them. No, it was not that. No. It was Alt X. Oh, damn it. It was Alt X. Oh, there it was. I know it, and I can play Tetris with it. Every kind of game you can play with it is really nice. Yeah, you can do a lot with it, and also program, but I have no idea how it works, but people are still using it, so it must be good, I think. How do I need to close it? Just like... So you have a lot of shortcuts you need to know. There's also even a website for it, Fun with Emacs, and you also see, like this, Emacs is really really nice. It has a curve, and then you are help me. Sorry? Yeah. And then you also have Visual Studio and VI. It's very difficult, but if you know it, it is really it's really good. So, yeah, there was one guy using Emacs, Respect. And we also have IntelliJ. Yeah, it's got huge features, I think. So why are people leaving from certain IDEs? Why? So I asked that also in a second research, and they were saying, hey, I'm leaving, I already left Eclipse for example, IntelliJ. So you see, for example, I'm also such a user. I was moving from Eclipse to IntelliJ. And yeah, who has done the same? Yeah, almost 50%. That's a lot, I think. And who was leaving NetBeans? Okay, three, that's less. Okay, and Eclipse? Oh, that was already said. IntelliJ? Nobody left IntelliJ. Okay, that's something to say. And the most winners, like expected, is IntelliJ. Yeah, IntelliJ is a good idea, I think. And also you see a lot of people are switching still to Eclipse. And NetBeans, of course, and 10% or to Visual Studio Code. But why are people switching? That's the question. Now, because of performance. My own problem was debugging. I don't like debugging in Eclipse, so I switched to IntelliJ and I was seeing, hey, it's much easier right now. I don't have compilation errors and that kind of things. There are features, of course, complexity and so on, support, user experience. So the next thing is, yeah, which IDE to use in which situation? So I ask again to my colleague, what is important, he think?
Yeah, for me, a good IDE should definitely have a few features, a few functionalities, which I believe it's must have. For example, I would expect to have a big marketplace where I can find lots of plugins. I would also expect an IDE which it can be easy to use, it can be fast, it doesn't really use lots of resources of my machine. I would expect also a big community so that I can find answers to my questions. And the most important of all, I think, I would expect to be able to write code in a handy way using auto-completion features. And of course, if something goes wrong, I would like to have lots of debug features or functionalities or capabilities so I can easily and quickly find what's wrong with my code.
So no applause this time. So what did he say? Yeah, he thinks that a big marketplace is important. So let's check that also. He thinks support is very handy. It needs to be free, but yeah, I don't think so. But you need to have releases, community, easiest, fast. There's a lot of to discuss, but I will discuss on the next sheets. You need a big marketplace with a lot of plugins. So let's check the plugins. Now in IntelliJ, you have a lot of plugins. 3200, so a lot you can choose. Same for Eclipse, 1600, it's a little bit less. In Visual Studio Code, they really have a huge plugin, so a lot of plugins they have, almost 10,000. NetBeans also have 1100 entries, so they have 1100 plugins. So, yeah, Visual Studio Code. I have a lot of plugins. If you need that, you choose that plugin. But yeah, it needs to be good, of course. But I also like to pair programming. So I was checking that. How can I check together with other juniors how to program? So pair program is now it's not possible, but in IntelliJ it is going to be possible, I think. Later on, there's a ticket for that. But in Visual Studio Code, it's there. You can pair programming with your colleagues. So I make a video of it because I don't like the demo gods. There is already a long time, or a couple of weeks. Okay, then okay, nice. I would check it definitely. Is it good? Yeah, even better than Visual Studio Code.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, nice. I would definitely try it. It's one of my most wanted features. Yeah, you would see, of course, the pair program. You see the name, who is changing what. And in Visual Studio Code is possible, and now also in IntelliJ, of course. And it's nice to pair program with your juniors. If you are a team lead or something, then you can do it together. If you're not at home, or if you are at home, for example. So yeah, this is the Visual Studio Code plugin. I really like that one. You also have for Eclipse, you have the web browser. So it's also a kind of pair program you can do in it. So yeah, okay.
It still exists.
Okay, you used it one time?
Yeah, like 12 years ago. Yeah,
wow, is it still supported?
I don't know.
okay. Yeah, I never have seen it. So yeah, I've seen Eclipse in the web browser. It's really nice, I think. But I wanted to try it, but yeah, I've got a lot of problems with Docker and that kind of thing. So I have a picture for that. So if you want to easily do code reviews, so in Visual Studio Code you can make comments in your IDE. That's nice, instead going to a web page. This is the GitHub plugin, for example. So it's really nice that you install a plugin and then you are going to check the pull request. A lot of Maven trouble in it. But it's good. You can make a comment here. Who had even used this one? Nobody used it already? Okay, nice. So you can create comments. It's nice to check each other's comments. And yeah, you can do a comment instead of starting up your browser. You can just do it in your browser. So. In IntelliJ they raise a feature also. I hope they will implement it also because I like it. Support, default supported languages in Eclipse. You will see a lot of it's focused on Java, of course, and HTML and C. In Visual Studio Code, you see it's focused mainly on front end, but you have a lot of plugins in Visual Studio Code you can install, like the Java plugin supported by Red Hat. NetBeans had a lot of support, and IntelliJ, of course, had huge support for almost everything. So that's good to see. And the most releases, Visual Studio Code is releasing once a month, so that's good, I think. IntelliJ is having three big releases in a year. And NetBeans, Eclipse also have some releases. And you have for IntelliJ, you have the Early Access Program. If you want to see the latest features, you need to install that one. Then you have the latest features. And you have it also for Visual Studio Code Insiders. So if you want the most active community, how many contributors are there? There are a lot of contributors in IntelliJ. This is the free edition. Eclipse, you cannot see it. It's closed, I think. But you see NetBeans at 88 contributors and Visual Studio Code also a lot. So it's good. If you want the easiest IDE for junior developers, you need to use the one everyone is using. So that's handy. Just use, if you're all using IntelliJ, you also need to use IntelliJ, I would say. Or if you're using all Eclipse, then it needs to be using Eclipse. So the fastest IDE. So who will think IntelliJ will be the fastest? No one? Yeah, one. Visual Studio Code. Free. NetBeans? Nobody? Okay. Eclipse? Okay, so it's most, I think, yeah, a lot of people are saying Visual Studio Code. So let's check it. Let's start it up. So I'm cutting the time. Gives me some time to drink some water. So Eclipse started in 15 seconds almost. So that's it's okay. But yeah, it's not about starting up, right? Because you only start it up once and then it's okay. So yeah, it's just want to see it how fast it was. So IntelliJ was around 30 seconds because it needs to analyze some files, indexing, that kind of things. If you're using Maven, maybe it needs index that one. So it has a reason why it's causing so long. It's doing so long. So it's 30 seconds, and NetBeans you will see. Can I fast forward it? I go just go to the next one, I think. Yeah. But there's NetBeans. It's fast. It's okay. It's also checking some projects. And you have Visual Studio Code. That's taking too much time. Let's do it like this. And 11 seconds for Visual Studio Code. So yeah, you will see Visual Studio Code is the quickest when started up, and then Eclipse, NetBeans, and IntelliJ. But that has a reason, I think, because yeah, IntelliJ has a lot of features to load, because yeah, Visual Studio Code is, yeah, you need to install a lot of plugins. If you install a lot of plugins, it will be slower. So it's, yeah, it's like expected, I think. So if you want to less resource taken, yeah, we can check just opening all the IDEs. And then we're just checking, Emacs, well, later on. IDE, you will see it's around 650. Eclipse, 570. And you will see NetBeans, 800 even. And you have code. But Visual Studio Code is made by Electron. It's also used by Chrome. And it has a lot of helpers. So you need to add them. So around 300 or something, I will guess. So that's the less resource taken. So like I said, IntelliJ, you have a download size of 700, 190, Eclipse, Visual Studio Code 70, and NetBeans 113. So yeah, if you want the best design, yeah, it's just a matter of taste, I think. The first impression of IntelliJ, you have a lot of plugins for it, like the dark theme. You have it also for Eclipse. Yeah, it's a matter of taste, I think. And then you have Visual Studio Code. It's a default black theme. So it's a matter of taste, I think. So if you want to act like a boss, the only paid one now known is by IntelliJ. And but I think that's a reason. So auto completion, we have auto completion array copy this time. Yeah, IntelliJ has a really nice auto completion. A post fix completion also. You can do for loops. You can you just say item and a for, and then you have a whole for loop. That's really nice. And the same for try catches. You can just postfix. You can say, "Hey, try," and then it's creating a try catch block. For example, I like that feature. It saves you some time, but it's even better to write streams, I think. But you have auto completion for Eclipse also, of course, and you have some Java doc in Eclipse and Java doc. Yeah, it's also nice to see how it's working. You also have a postfix completion. Yeah, you need to install a plugin for that in Eclipse. an auto-completion for IntelliJ, of in Visual Studio called. It's called IntelliSense. So you have you don't have postfix completion in Visual Studio Code. You have auto-completion from NetBeans also. Yeah, it's all the same. Postfix completion, they don't do it because you need to say, first you need to say if, and yeah, the expression will be there instead of post. Yeah, like I said, if you want the debugging, debugging in IntelliJ is very good. If you if you see it, everyone is using it, of course. If you click on Alt with the shortcut, you even see the exception. And yeah, the same. And what I like of IntelliJ is this. I like the support for debugging streams in this case. So you have to set a breakpoint, for example, and then your Spring is booting up. Sorry, no Micronaut. So then it's starting up. It takes some time. This is a good reason maybe to try Micronaut. And then you have a debug. And then you can see you have debug support on streams. That's really nice. And you need to wait. And then you have some... yeah, the debugging, that's really nice. So a question to the audience. What do you like? Can I use a microphone maybe? How's it working? Yeah, it's still on? Okay. Yeah. Okay. I want to ask, what do you think is the best feature, for example, in IntelliJ? I can ask you, why are you using IntelliJ?
First of all, because I'm used to it, and I really like the debugging features, and it works really, really well with the Grails and GSPs and navigation in a Grails app between artifacts.
Okay. And did I miss something on it?
I don't think so.
No? And now I'm searching for an Eclipse user. I saw someone. Like? What was it? Eclipse user? Was one, right? No! You don't want it? He switched to IntelliJ right now. No problem. But yeah, I have an Emacs user. So let's ask the Emacs user, why are you using Emacs and what's your role?
Yes, I guess it's because of the startup, the fastest startup.
Okay, that's the main reason?
Because if I don't have to use any refactoring of the base code, is really small, I don't want to, I mean, I don't need those features.
Okay.
But if I had to deal with a large base code, I normally use IntelliJ as well.
Okay.
So it depends on what I'm
using Java for it or for Emacs?
Yeah, Java, for example, if I'm programming Groovy, I'm okay with Emacs.
Okay.
But unless I have to do like a big refactoring, then I would use IntelliJ.
And you use the free edition of
Of IntelliJ.
Okay.
Yeah.
Plus points for Eclipse.
Okay, 2+ points. Are you an Eclipse user? No. Oh, damn it.
Let me explain, Ko.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm an IntelliJ user, but I switched from Eclipse to IntelliJ years ago.
And why?
Well, because all the cool kids were using IntelliJ when I looked around, so I thought, well, I want to be a cool kid, so I switched to.
Yeah.
Had a bit of a steep learning curve back then, but managed it. And the cool thing of IntelliJ, by the way, is all the nice shortcuts and Control Shift A that you can look up the shortcuts.
Yeah,
that's really helpful.
Okay.
But now I'm working in a team with Eclipse users, and there are actually two features that Eclipse has that IntelliJ does not. At least not out of the box. One of them, the most important one to this team, is that Eclipse has workspaces. And that bundles up a whole bunch of projects that are actually unrelated, sort of, in that they do not share a common parent POM, for instance, if it's a Maven project, and this is Maven project. So you can easily change stuff in some project in your workspace, in your IDE, and directly import it in some other project.
Okay.
That's handy. And the other one is that Git has auto fetch in Eclipse and also in a lot of other tools, but in IntelliJ it does not. You have now a plugin for that, of course, but out of the box it does not. Okay. That's not very handy.
Oh, interesting. Yeah. Ah, thanks, Frank. Yeah?
I would like to add something.
Yeah. Oh, we have a battle. We have a battle, guys.
Yes. Because I believe that IntelliJ, you can just import a SOP module that has no relation to other pieces of code, and that will work equally as well.
In IntelliJ, you can just import the submodule, but the parent is not the POM.
It doesn't have to have a common connection.
Wait.
You want a battle, right?
Yeah, we have a battle, yeah.
You make me defend Eclipse, that's...
No.
Yeah, it's probably module by module, but yeah, well, my solution is that I just make an artificial parent POM and put all the parents in there and use that.
Okay.
And then be done with it.
Yeah.
But yeah.
But
but my coworkers did best me with it.
Yeah. Nice. Thank you, guys. NetBeans? We have one NetBeans user, maybe? I don't want to say it, no? Not too bad, okay. Thanks. So let's go on with the next one. So yeah, I like the debugging in Eclipse, debugging in Visual Studio Code, and NetBeans, yeah, they look a little bit all the same, I think, but yeah, IntelliJ, I think, rocks in it. So what I want to say is just try some other IDE I want to say. Yeah, it's, of course, IntelliJ is really almost perfect, so that's really nice, but yeah, don't lose your focus. Just try some other IDE also, I want to say, even if it's after lunchtime. So another question, if you need to switch from something to something, you switch to Visual Studio Code? Who want to switch to Visual Studio Code? We have a few. Eclipse, maybe? No, NetBeans? And who just stay at IntelliJ? Okay, the most are staying to IntelliJ. Okay, nice. Yeah, if you need to switch, yeah. Yeah, yeah. No, staying is not an option, so yeah. So my Pokemon is IntelliJ, of course. I really like the Pokemon, but I'm also trying to catch Visual Studio Code Pokemon, because of the feature, the release thingy. They got a lot of releases with good things in it, with good plugins and that kind of things. So, and also follow ThoughtWorks. They also have Visual Studio Code in it. They're saying, hey, it's a trend. Everyone is trialing with it. So maybe I need to also to check it. The same for the Visual Live share. So yeah. I will recommend it indeed, the technology rate. It's really cool. So I was curious why people are using Visual Studio Code. So I'm going to use it myself. But you need a lot of to install a lot of plugins. You need some time to install it. You need for everything you need to do something manually, like creating Maven tasks and that kind of things. And it's very strict to Maven. You need to set, if you want to use streams, then you need to set the Maven to 1.8. Otherwise, it's not working. Sometimes missing documentation. But I like the fact, I'm positive, because it's very quick. Quickly download, installed, smoothly designed, good source control, grid layout. And Java support is there since 2017, I think. I was checking the GitHub repo for that. And yeah, I also saw this in research. People laugh at me because I'm different. I laugh at them because they are all the same. And I was thinking, is this Albert Einstein or something? Why? Yeah. What? So. No, it was the lead singer of Nirvana. I googled it, so there was a nice something from my research. So yeah, just try something where you're used in it, or yeah. So we have the poker cards. Great support, debug completion in IntelliJ. de Eclipsinator, open source, free plugin, support. Visual Studio Code is fast, is open source, free, and it's low resources. The integration in Maven was good, and the NetBeans, and also Gradle works out of the box, and the support. But you also need a skill card, so yeah, please use the shortcuts, I would say. And yeah, have the courage to just try something else, or yeah, just or don't. So learn shortcuts, I would want to say. You have an IntelliJ, you have a really nice, yeah, you have a really nice plugin, the key promoter. You install it, and every time you use the mouse, for example, then it's complaining about just use the keyboard. And sometimes it's frustrating, but it works very good. Yeah. Another question, last question, and then what do you think is the best plugin in IntelliJ? Yeah, thanks. Someone? Nobody? For Visual Studio Code? Yeah, there. Yeah. No. No. What do you like on Visual Studio Code, I think? Which plugin is the best, you think?
I don't know, but for me, I used to use Material DIMP, DEMS, to change the visual appearance
and
the code color.
Okay.
Because it's better for me to read the code than the original DEMS.
Okay.
For your mates.
Okay. Oh, nice. Cool. I like the Sonalint plugin of IntelliJ, for example. It's really nice to check your quality of your project, I think. I like that. I like that one. So, yeah. Please provide me feedback at this URL, like everyone does. Thank you for watching and looking. Right on time. A minute. So one other question. Nice.
Another question. I think I would also suggest the ASCII Doctor plugin for IntelliJ. It's very nice. So support for Plant2ML also.
Oh, sorry?
What? Didn't understand. I would suggest the ASCII Doctor plugin for
IntelliJ. Okay.
Very nice support.
Okay, nice. Definitely check it. Nice.
My question is for teams working with different IDEs, IntelliJ, Eclipse, and so on, most of those IDEs are doing auto-formatting in different waves. So for pull requests and things like that, it's quite painful. I know there are some plugins and also in Gradle to solve that, but it doesn't work too well, or at least it has some difficulties. Any advice from you about that or for someone in the audience?
Yeah, mostly you have. You want to say it? About? You want? To, oh, nice. Okay. Yeah, it's even easy. Let's give it in there. Kind of battle.
Yeah, at least in my company, there are many people using very different types of IDEs. So, for example, you have the editor config, which is kind of universal. If you attach it to the project, every editor or IDE normally recognize it. So, if you are concerned about tabs and things like that, you can use the editor. And also, you can have your build tool like checking the syntax, like, for example, spotless for Gradle. I don't know if for Maven, but at least for Gradle, that it gives you like the same syntax and rules for everybody.
Okay, thank you. You're satisfied with that? Okay, nice. Thank you. You earn a license of me, an IntelliJ license. Thank you.
Okay,
no questions? Okay, thanks, guys.